Welcome to Getting Started on Android. This is a crash course in Android development, and this short video is meant to show you exactly how easy it is to get started. Whether this is your 100th startup or your first time coding, there's something to learn for everyone. Before you build, you'll have to make important decisions with your team, like whether to build an app or a mobile website, and the kind of user experience you want to create. You should also ask what you want your users to be able to do with what you build. Once you've made these decisions, bring your wireframes along and let's get started.
If you haven't installed it yet, take a moment to do that now using the detailed instructions provided in the link below. Open up the Android SDK Manager to see what tools, platform versions, and components we have installed. At the time of this recording, the Android L platform is available, but it's still in developer preview mode. That means it's subject to change until the official release. And you can't upload your app to Google Play if it's targeting this L platform version. Hence, we want to use the latest stable platform version. Deselect all the other packages and just choose the ones for API level 19. We want the SDK as well as the system images for the emulator. We also want the Android support library for backwards compatibility. We pick the latest version of Gingerbread at API level 10 because it contains bug fixes that API level 9 doesn't have. Then we go ahead and click Next. We're going to pick the blank activity with fragment template. For background context, an activity serves as a presentation layer for our UI, and the fragment within it represents a behavior or portion of the screen. Now, for the moment you've been waiting for, let's run the app by clicking on this button. It will prompt us to choose a device. Without a physical device, we can use the emulator, which is included in the Android SDK. Currently, it says that there are no Android virtual devices available. So let's open up the AVD manager to create one. Then click New. By creating an AVD, we can configure an emulated device with the Android platform version that we want to test on, as well as hardware options. When it loads up, we see our Sunshine app with the words, "Hello World." And then we'll need to enable USB debugging. This can be found in Developer Options in the Settings app. To find the secret menu, go to the Settings app. Scroll down to About Phone, then go down to Build Number and tap on that 7 times. Then, when you go back to settings, you'll see the developer options menu appear. Now in Android Studio, you can hit the play button to run the app on your device. In the device chooser dialog, you should see your connected device. To prevent the dialog from popping up in future times, check this box. Then hit OK to continue. Within a few moments, you should see it on your phone.
In design, we have a technique. It's called wireframing, or low-res wireframing. Imagine there's a task that your user wants to complete. So for this example, it's, I'm hungry for cookies, I want to get some and eat the cookies, basically. So then you think about, what steps does your user need to go through to complete this task? So this is an easy example because we only have one task. So the steps would be sign in, decide which cookies you want, pay for your cookies, and then eat the cookies. So when we write out each of these steps at a high level like this, each of these steps is kind of like a Java interface.
Exactly. When you think about a Java interface, it's something that doesn't have any implementation, so you're not really thinking about the low-level details, but you're thinking about the contract that interface has with other interfaces and classes, which in this case, if you look at the steps, it's how do these steps connect with each other. So instead of focusing on just one step and nothing else, you're really thinking about the big picture.
This has the correct flow for how the user will interact with the app, but it doesn't have the final visual look and feel yet. We'll build this up step by step, starting with the main activity. Then we'll move on to the detail activity, and then later build up the tablet UI.
Main activity is launched when you start the app. At the bottom of main activity, we have placeholder fragment. Placeholder fragment was generated by the template we used when creating our project. A fragment is a modular container within your activity. In later lessons, we'll look at how to use multiple fragments in a single activity, and we'll actually explain why we're using them at all. But for now, our activity contains just this one fragment. So here in placeholder fragment is where we reference our UI layout resource, called fragment main. This XML file lives in the resources, res directory, of our project folder. You can see other kinds of resources here besides layouts, such as design assets or drawables, or strings. When our activity runs, it creates this placeholder fragment, which then inflates the XML layout resource, converting everything in the XML file to a hierarchy of view objects in memory. by holding Control or Command, depending on your operating system, and clicking on this reference to Fragment Main. Android Studio will drop us right into the Visual Layout Editor. Once we're inside a layout XML file, we can switch between the Design tab, where we can drag and drop new UI elements and modify the layout visually, and the Text tab, where we can see and edit the XML that defines the layout and UI elements.
In order to build a UI in Android, we use views. Views are rectangles on the screen, and we may or may not see the borders of that rectangle. Essentially, a view handles drawing and event handling, and all the basic widgets in Android extend from this base class. The Android Design Guide has visual examples of these basic building blocks of apps.
Imagine spending hours crafting the perfect layout. What happens to that layout when you rotate the device into a landscape orientation, or when it's run on a device with a much larger screen? The good news is that Android provides excellent tools to help you with layouts. You'll want to understand them to make your app look amazing across the wide variety of phones, tablets, and other devices you'll want your app to work on. Today, the lines between phones and tablets are disappearing, so it's important to think about how your UI will scale in our multi-screen world. Don't be overwhelmed. Just like designing responsive layouts for the web, build your layouts to be reasonably flexible or within a common device size. Then you can set breakpoints, providing alternative layouts for those various sizes.
All externalized Android resources, everything from strings to layouts to drawables and animations, are all stored within your project's res folder. You've already been putting your strings in the strings XML file stored in the values folder, and you've been putting your layouts into the layout folder. And you know to reference your resources using at notation within both your XML or within the code, and then at runtime, Android will insert the appropriate resource for you. So far, so good. And here's where things get a little more interesting. Android allows you to create alternative versions of every resource by placing them into folders with different qualifiers. We separate each of those using a hyphen. And we can add those qualifiers based on anything from language and or dialect to whether the device is docked, the type of touchscreen, the pixel density of the display, the orientation of the screen, and most importantly, for responsive design in particular, the smallest available screen width, which you can support with that layout.
This was a lightweight introduction to Android development. You can learn more by checking out our full Udacity course to get the full content, or by visiting the Android developer site. If you're ready to distribute and monetize, you should check out our great resources, including quality guidelines and go-to-market processes for startups at g.co/launch. All the best and happy coding.